Well, we've really come full circle on the Hearts Vying For modding community now, because we've come back to what if this country was swapped with another one, but instead of that out there, it's just what if we just moved this country all the way over here. But before we get into that, I need to mention that YouTube now has a channel sponsor button, which you will see next to my videos now with a little join button. And I have decided I will be giving this feature a go. I'm not entirely sure how much it will benefit me in the end, but I am going to be giving a few benefits and perks to people who do decide to actually support the channel, because monetization is a bit hit or miss on YouTube at the moment. A few of the benefits and perks I will be offering are as follows. A special iSorrowproductions icon next to your name when you leave a comment, some iSorrowproductions emojis, and on top of that, you also get access to the community members only part of my YouTube channel. Here you can see some behind the scenes stuff, which I will try to post every couple days. On top of that, you will also have access to some of the videos that I might put up a day or two early, specifically vlog type videos. And the last perk or benefit is going to be a poll every week, which I will put a whole bunch of new games or whole new mods on that I'm gonna have people vote on to see which I do a video on. As I understand, Hoi4's getting a bit stale with no updates or anything coming out. There's no big mods. So what I'm going to be doing is trying to play a new game every week, which I'm going to let you guys vote on who's sponsor. But either way, I've left a link to it in the description as well if you can't see the join button because you're using the old YouTube layout. And to anyone that does join or hit the sponsor button, thank you very much. And if you're wondering how you can support the channel any other way because you can't give money, which is completely understandable, a simple like or hitting the subscribe button will do. But anyway, sorry for the long intro. Let's get right into it. Oh man, I haven't looked at vanilla Hearts of Iron 4 in so long. It's kind of burning my eyes. Oh god, I just need to look at something just a bit weird. I just can't do these borders. Oh wait, there you go, that fixed it. That's right guys, what if Japan and Britain were giving Ireland a good old spit roast? Okay, that's not what the mod's called, but it would be much better if it was called that. Now you may all be wondering exactly how this is going to affect the game, and honestly it's probably not gonna change that much really. Japan just right next to Britain, a major power that's also axis. How the hell would that change anything? Also, kind of forgot a few bits and pieces on our very quick move out. Who cares anyway? It's not the first time someone dumped a bunch of trash in the Pacific Ocean, am I right? Now, I wasn't going to point this out, Mr. Hirohito, but did you do something different? Are you oh, you've got some new blusher. That's it. Yeah, I'm sorry about this, Britain, but this whole, you know, spit roasting Ireland thing we had between us, it was okay for a while, but now it's kind of getting a bit weird. So I feel like that's just not enough room for both of us to meddle in Irish affairs. And the best thing about invading Britain in 1937 is that they're at the height of, please Germany, don't invade half of Europe, please, pretty please. Which makes them very easy to invade, as their only defense is sitting around in a circle holding hands and singing sweet old Blighter take me home. Funnily enough, this naval battle's been going on since the start of the war, and it's just looking like it's never ever going to end. I've sunk a bunch of British battleships and all sorts, but it's kind of like, maybe we should call it off, guys. We've been here for like a month or two now. Can we just go home? But it does not matter either way, as Britain is about to capitulate when I take Dover. So I'm sorry, but there can only be one in these British Isles. Except for, you know, Ireland. But that's mostly because I can't be bothered to invade them. Not so much what if Japan was in Europe, more so what if Japan was just Britain at this point. You know, I guess they're pretty similar. They both like tea. They're both on an island. They've both committed a whole bunch of imperialism and war crimes. They're basically the Britain of the East. Although technically they are now the Britain of the East, because Britain's actually in the West, stuck in New Finland, which is going to be good for them. I they're going to do so much good on that place. But I don't feel like we should stick with our current government, which is fascist in the game. I feel like we need to pick a new government that fits our new British imperialism. Banzai! Oh god, I completely forgot, if you go down this part of the focus tree, you turn into this eye-blisteringly colourful white. God, when they said Land of the Rising Sun, I didn't think they meant this. Oh, the Czech said no to Germany, which is pretty interesting considering no one's going to help you. Oh, hold on a sec, I said I wasn't going to get involved in China, but if you're going to start blowing up my factories. And to think I was just going to let China have its own little happy fun time. Best part about going blisteringly eye-watering white-colored Japan is you don't get any of the negative bonuses for invading China, so this is an incredibly easy war. Again, I wasn't even going to invade China, but you guys just had to bomb my factory. Germany hasn't really been up to much. They took Poland and Czechoslovakia, but they haven't done much other than that. They've got their war goals on the Benelux, and they're about to get one on France, so maybe we're about to see Germany actually just fully annex France. I'd create a faction with them, but
I'm Japan, and I'm too stupid to make faction because it's really hard without a national spirit.
Well, I feel like I should get involved somehow, but I feel like it's going to be way too late before I can actually do anything. Oh, and they went straight toward the Soviets as soon as they annexed France, which means I don't think the Soviets are going to have this one. Oh god, Italy's actually invading places. This is horrifying. Oh, there you go. They declared war on Greece. That should even things out, because there's no way Italy's going to be able to take out Greece. Oh my god! Yeah, this axis is way too powerful. I'm just going to have to get involved. I can't watch this. Romania's go. Everyone's go. I've got to take them out. Ah. Well, that's top 10 anime plot twists right there. Yeah, I need to take some of the pressure off the Soviets here, because they're not going to last too much longer. So, D-Day, I suppose? I'm not in any way, shape, or form ready for this. You see, where I lack, like, competent infantry and tanks, I have a shit ton of planes. Well, my advance, it got much further than I thought it would. I've managed to push out some tanks too, but the Germans aren't looking too healthy here, and this Eastern Front has actually been pushed back a little bit. I'm just confused as anyone how that managed to happen. Well, the Germans are dead, but unfortunately the Italians, the Hungarians, and really big Romania still exists. Silly Romanians, you've got no right being that big. I managed to cut off the rest of these Axis troops over here in Russia. Just gotta take Sevastopol in this port, and they are basically done for. Well, talk about way too effing late for that one, Mr. Roosevelt. What the hell took you so long? And with Romania capitulate, that means they should all be out of... Oh my god, look at all the Italian troops, just like a cancer upon Russia. Oh god. Well, there's the Axis done, but I'm not done just yet. And I think, like, instituting monarchies back in countries that got rid of them. Good old Felician Hawk and Otto Wagner, famous German and French monarch. Now, obviously, going down this part of Japan's focus tree, there is one guy you're supposed to go to war with. It's not China, Britain, the Axis. It's actually Stalin, believe it or not. Wait a sec. Is it too late to have a non-aggression pact with China? I feel like it might be a little bit too late. Oh, well, no, apparently it's not too late. China does want a non-aggression pact with me, even though they are my puppet. Why do they keep doing this to me recently? Manchuko, I will not be your goddamn puppet. In fact, I will not be your puppet so hard that I'm just going to go ahead and do something I probably should have done a few years ago. That's right. See you later, Manchuko. Well, I've never seen this happen before, but the Soviets actually gave me North Sakhalin. I've never seen them actually do that. So I noticed I'm locked out of this part of my focus tree because, you know, I can't create a faction. So I'm just going to go ahead and use the allow diplo command to actually allow me to, you know, do a faction. Even though apparently, according to the game, no one can just create a faction. It's very special, and you can't do it because you don't have the national spirit to do. Fuck off, all right? Just piss off, Paradox. I don't really know what this infantry template really is, but I know it's definitely best represented by this bird. This green arrow has been here for a very long time. I don't know what it used to be, where it's going, or why it's been here for literally like 2 years now. Well, Joni, I hope you're ready for round 2 Electric Boogaloo. Invade the Soviets and hopefully they don't gulag you. Oh, well, the German Empire denounced our war with the Soviets, which is a bit interesting considering they are the front line of the current Soviet offensive. Oh, no. The Soviets only went and sank the Zhanos. Yeah, surprisingly wasn't that hard. Well, that was all they wrote for What If Japan Was Somehow in Europe, and I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you leave a like at the subscribe button, and if you do want to join the channel and become a channel member, feel free to do that down below. It should be in the description, or as you can see right next to the sub button, it will be there. And I will be throwing up the next poll on what game I shall play in a couple hours after this video goes live. And before you ask, everyone, the CK2 video is already done, and it will be out this weekend.